Hello YouTubers. Now, I was driving home yesterday and everything was fine, and all of a sudden my clutch pedals went straight to the deck. And obviously, shit, now it was the master cylinder or the slave cylinder, so I was still able to drive with the revs of the car. I could change up and down gears, so I could still, at least I got home. It could be a couple of things, and I was obviously the main thing I was thinking of is actually the slave cylinder had cracked or popped, and of course the fluid leaking out, and that's why I got no clutch. That's what I first thought even. So I got home anyway, and I checked the reservoir and it was full. Now that's a good sign, because at least you know there's no physical leaks anywhere, that it's full. And I noticed, which I'll show you in a second, I noticed that the brake fluid and the clutch fluid seems to be all black and kind of grimy. Now, I replaced the clutch in this a few years ago when I got the car, because when I got the car, the clutch was gone, so I replaced the clutch. I put a solid flywheel in it, a clutch release bearing, and put the full works in it. So it shouldn't have gone this quick. You know, I don't ride the clutch, so it shouldn't have gone this quick. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm hoping what it is just shit or water has got into the brake fluid, which does happen over a period of time, and I'm just gonna flush the system, and hopefully it's gonna be fine. Because when I got home, I lifted the pedal up manually, and it's working, it worked. I left it last night, and put my foot down, and went straight to deck again. Lifted it up by hand, and I drove it to the shed, and it was used the clutch no problem. So that's why I'm kind of hoping it's just maybe a bit of shit got in there somewhere. Fingers crossed, because it's a 2 litre diesel Mondeo, and to take the gearbox out, a fucking nightmare. It's just very tight. Take the subframe off, I just move the gearbox to the side, but there's just hardly any room. It's a nightmare. So I'm going to show you the reservoir and show you what I mean by the colour, and then show you how to bleed the system, and hopefully just get all the crap out and replace it with fresh fluid. Even though I only did that a few years ago, so even that's a bit dodgy why it's done that. So let's show you. Now, this is my brake and clutch reservoir. That's the clutch coming off here. Now, like I said, if there was hardly any fluid in here, then you would know there's a problem. It could be the pipe that's split, or it could be the actual slave cylinder inside the gearbox which is split, which is a nightmare. But I don't know if you can see that, but basically, if you look down there, that's a little cover, but you can see how, you can't really see on camera, but anyway, the fluid's all kind of black and horrible, which isn't great. I can't get this off, you can't quite see on camera, but if the fluid should be nice and clear, and obviously, like I said, what does happen is water over a period of time can get in, so it's always best just to check this every couple of years anyway. Now, the problem is to bleed this clutch is right underneath where the battery is. So it looks like I'm gonna have to take the battery out. Not a big deal, but just you could lose your radio code and just a bit fucking nightmare, but you're not gonna be able to see it, but it's down there in the depths. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take off the battery and I'm gonna show you the bleed nipple on the clutch. And just to give you an idea, this is what DOT4 brake fluid looks like, brake and clutch fluid. So it should kind of look like that kind of colour, and as you can see, nice and fresh. The stuff I've got in there is kind of black, horrible, grimy. All I'm going to do is just take off the battery. Just a couple of 10 mils, the bracket here, the battery should lift off, a couple of bolts on the battery tray, and we should be able to see where we're going. Quick tip I always like to do is I do the power first, and the reason why is if you take off the earth and it touches the body, it's still doing the same thing, it's still earthing, so you can still have a problem. So I just take off the power first. It doesn't really matter, it's just the way I personally like to do it. So I'm going to take off the power wire first and make sure it's completely out of the way and it can't go anywhere. Then I'll physically take off the earth. Thank you. All I was doing there was a couple of little plastic clips and I was just pushing them out of the way. So this tray is now off. Now, unfortunately, it's very difficult for me to show you inside the engine. I'm going to try, but this is basically what one looks like. This is not out of this car. This is out of a Focus, if I believe. But this is a hydraulic cylinder. This is what moves in and out when you press the clutch. And then this is the end that sticks out of your gearbox. This is the pipe that goes in, and this is your bleed nipple. Now, on this particular one, all you need to do is turn this 180 degrees, and the fluid comes out, and you turn it back. Now, there's two ways of bleeding it. You either get your mate to help you pump the pedal. When he puts the pedal down, you open it, let all the air and fluid come out, then you lock it and he pumps it again. You do that a few times until you get a pedal. Some cars, it could take half an hour to do it that way. Some cars can take less and even a bit more. The way I'm going to do it, because I'm on my own, is I'm going to use my pressure bottle that I squeeze, put pressure onto the system, open up the bleed nipple. Hopefully I'm going to be seeing a bit of air coming out, if not some really old crappy fluid. And then once the fluid starts becoming clear, I'm just going to lock it up and hopefully that's going to be me solved. That's what one looks like. Now, unfortunately, I don't know if you can see this, but on this particular one, it's right there. You can just see where my finger is, middle finger, there, look. So as you can see, I can't really gonna show this one. I'm not gonna be able to show this on camera. Now, as you can see, this is the gadget I'm gonna be using. It just means I can do it on my own. It's gonna do one of two things. If there is a hole anywhere, once I start pressurizing it, it's gonna leak. So I'm gonna know there's a hole. And two, it's gonna save me an extra person. There's a little gauge on this far side, just here. I'm gonna pump it to just under 2 bar, just by using this. Puts pressure in the system. And I'm gonna go down and I'm gonna release the bleed nut, just like I showed you on that other one. But this one is an actual nut, so I have to physically squeeze it. Normally 10, 11 mil, depending on the car. And then literally just wait. If there's any air in it, if there is, I don't know how I got into it. I hope there is an air, because that there's a problem somewhere. I'm hoping it's just thick, kind of black, horribly fluid or something like that. I can't see any obvious signs of leaks. And like I said, I didn't need to put any fluid in there. But what's important is when you use something like this, you can get loads of different ones. Make sure you put brake fluid inside this, because once you pressurize it and let brake fluid off, if you had no brake fluid inside this, all that's going to happen is all the brake fluid in the container, in the tank here, it's just going to drain out. And if too much of it drains, that means you have to bleed the brakes and bleed absolutely everything. So I don't want to go down that route. So that's what I'm going to do. Now, we're just under... Well, just back bang on 2 bar there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to check to make sure I can't see anything leaking, why this isn't on under pressure. Check the pipe going all the way back, and also check underneath the car where the gearbox meets the engine to make sure it's not dripping there. Everything on top looks good, so I'm going to check the bottom. Again, everything on the bottom looks good as well, so hopefully I'm just gonna undo this and fingers crossed. 11 mil, I think. Can't get directly over the top of it. and try a spanner instead. I can't get directly over top of it with the ratchet. And I can't get any swing with it with that. I'm going to try with a smaller ratchet rod, or a smaller socket rather than a long reach one. Hopefully that will do it. Nope. My last hope now is a wobbly bar. I've shown you one of these before in my videos. It just gives it that much room to move, a bit like a knuckle. So you can see all the movement there. Hopefully this will work now. That's worked. Now the fluid's coming out. Keep an eye on everything. Can't see any air. Looks very thick and horrible. Give it a... now. I'm closing up at that. What's important now is to relieve the pressure off this. Take it off. I'm just going to check the clutch now to make sure the clutch is still there and it hasn't gone down. And hopefully that's it. So now YouTubers, that feels good. The pedal is going all the way down, it's coming all the way up, which is important. If it's only coming halfway up, then you've still got problems somewhere else. Like I said, it was an unusual one. I can't see any leaks. I hope I've sold it, I'm not sure yet. If you hear from me again in another video, you know I haven't. But if you don't, then all's good. So yeah, that's basically it. That's how you would bleed a clutch as well, if you were to put a new clutch in. It's the same thing as what I've just done, just unfortunately, I just couldn't quite show you this because it was just in an awkward spot in the car, unfortunately. So that's it. Hopefully I won't have any problems. Hopefully if it happens to you, this is the quick and easiest fix and the cheapest fix, obviously. Now the other thing is, if your cylinder has gone, replace everything. Replace your clutch, replace everything, because if your cylinder's gone, your clutch is on the way out, or even the springs in the actual clutch plate could be worn or anything. I only replaced this a few years ago, so it shouldn't have gone in that time. Now, if you replace it a few years ago and your cylinder goes, take your clutch and everything out. If it all looks good, then you might just get away with a cylinder. But if you buy a car and you've had it a year, let's say, and the clutch goes and you don't know what it's done before, honestly, just replace everything. Put solid flywheels in. Dual match flywheels are an absolute waste of time. I don't know why they put them in cars anymore. It's just ridiculous. So, I hope this helped. Thumbs up, subscribe, and don't forget to get your hands dirty. See you for the next one.